In this video, we're investigating the graphs of the polar curves known as cardioids and limacons. We're going to look at three different graphs and plot them point by point and wrap up each one of those with an animation of how the curve is traced for increasing theta. So we begin with the cardioids, and we have two different versions. There's a plus or minus a cosine theta, a plus or minus a sine theta. And actually, the sine cardioids are just rotations of the cosine cardioids by an angle of pi over 2. We can see this in the trig identity, and I made a separate video today showing how you can take a cosine cardioid and transform it into a sine cardioid by doing a pi over 2 rotation, and I'll post a link to that real quick. In this example, we're just going to plot a cosine cardioid point by point by plugging in special angles. So I'm going to go through the first few of these at normal speed, and then we're just going to fast forward through the rest because it gets really tedious if we do it at normal speed. I'm going to start sensibly enough by plugging in theta equals 0. And this gives me an R value of 2 plus 2 cosine 0. But the cosine of 0 is 1. So I get 2 plus 2 for R. And that gives me 4. So my first point is going to be theta equals 0, R equals 4. And that puts us right here. Next, we'll go to theta equals pi over 6. R is going to be 2 plus 2 cosine pi over 6. But the cosine of pi over 6 is root 3 over 2. I can cancel the 2's, and I end up with 2 plus root 3. Now, it's really useful to just get decimal approximations on these. And root 3 is a little bigger than 1.7, so I'm going to call this 3.7. So we look at the direction pi over 6, and we go 1, 2, 3, and almost 4, so about 3.7 units in that direction. Next, we do theta equals pi over 4. And cosine pi over 4 is root 2 over 2, and the 2's cancel, so I get 2 plus root 2. And root 2 is about 1.4, so I get 3.4 for this. And that's something like this. Moving on to theta equals pi over 3. The cosine of pi over 3 is a half, and I get 2 plus 1, or R equals 3. Finally, we'll do theta equals pi over 2, and after that, I'm hitting the fast forward button. And I get R equals 2 plus 2 cosine pi over 2. The cosine of pi over 2 is 0, so R is equal to 2. All right, so we're starting to get a sense for how a curve is swept out as theta increases, and we're going to go all the way from 0 to 2 pi. That's how long it takes before this curve starts to repeat itself, because the cosine is periodic with a period of 2 pi. So let's speed things up a little. And we're done doing all the special angles. If you're watching carefully, you may have noticed I made a mistake on theta equals 2 pi over 3, so I originally wrote that in as 1.5, but it's actually 1, and it's been corrected now. So now all that's left to do is connect the points with a smooth curve. And I'm not going to torture you with my attempt to do this with a digital pad. I'm just going to bring in the animation, and we'll see how this thing is traced out as theta goes from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so there's our cardioid curve. And it's kind of a heart shape, which is why these things are called cardioids. Next, we're going to look at our first limacon. So the limacon curves are defined this way. You have an a cosine theta plus a b, or an a sine theta plus a b. Again, the sine version of these is just a pi over 2 rotation of the cosine version. And in our example, we're just going to do a cosine. And the limacons get divided into two different cases. And case one is where the size of A is less than the size of B. So in our example, A is 1 and B is 2. We have the curve R of theta equals cosine theta plus 2. Now what happens because of the relative size of these constants? I can see in my equation that cosine has a max value of 1 and a min value of negative 1. And because I've added a number to that that's bigger than 1, R can never be negative. So I'm always going to have a positive value of R. In fact, the minimum value of R is going to be 1, so it doesn't even touch the origin like the cardioid did. So again, we can start plugging in special angles. And when I plug in theta equals 0, I get R equals cosine of 0 plus 2, but the cosine of 0 is 1. So I get R equals 3, and my limacon starts here. Plug in theta equals pi over 6, and just rounding to the tens place, I get about 2.9 for this. And I think you get the idea of what's going to happen, so I'm just going to hit the fast forward button again. Okay, so that's probably enough of that. I wanted to point out for this graph that it has a symmetry that allows us to copy all the rest of the points without redoing the calculations. And the idea is that r of negative theta, because the cosine is an even function, the cosine of negative theta is just the cosine of theta. And this means as I'm sampling positive values of theta, I'll get the same point as if I sample the same negative value of theta. Well, that just copies out a reflection of this curve across the horizontal axis. So I can quickly get the rest of my points. And there's all the points on the limacon for the special angles. So let's bring in the animation of this guy as it's traced out from 0 to 2 pi. And there's our classic limacon with no loop. Finally, we're going to look at the second case of limacons, and that's where the size of A is bigger than the size of B. And in our example, A is larger than B because A is 2, B is 1. And what this is doing is doubling the amplitude of the cosine part. And so that cosine part goes between negative 2 and 2. And I see that it's possible now for r to become negative. Remember, negative r means you go the opposite direction of the angle that you're aiming at. The effect of this is that it creates a loop inside of a loop. So before we start plotting this, I want to point out that yet again, I have this symmetry that r of negative theta is equal to r of theta, which means it'll have a mirror symmetry about the horizontal axis. So we really only have to do about half of the work. And I start with theta equals 0. This gives me that r is equal to 2 times the cosine of 0 plus 1, but the cosine of 0 is 1, so I get r equals 3, and I'm here. And I'll go ahead and hit the fast forward button for the rest of these. All right, just a quick timeout. We just got our first negative value of r at theta equals 3 pi over 4, and my value of r is negative 0.4. So I'm going to aim in the direction of 3 pi over 4, but step backwards by 0.4 units, and I land right here. All right, half of the points on our limacon are done. And now we can use the idea of the symmetry of the curve to finish it. And finally, we'll bring in the animation to see what this looks like as the curve is swept out from theta equals 0 to theta equals 2 pi. Okay, that's pretty much it for cardioids and limacons. Just keep in mind, we did all cosine versions of these equations in this video, and the corresponding sine versions are just rotations counterclockwise through an angle of pi over 2. If you find the math content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.